I know what you are.
Say it out loud.
Vampire.
Edward and Bella are back on the big screen October 21st and 23rd for the 10th anniversary of Twilight.
I don't know how long I've waited for you.
With a sneak peek of the new featurette and a commemorative poster. Tickets available at fathomevents.com. Get it on 4K Ultra HD and digital. Also available, 3-disc Blu-ray combo packs.
Edward is the reluctant vampire who falls in love with Bella Swan. He was turned into a vampire by Carlisle, who he's now kind of adopted as his father figure. Basically, the Collins, well, dictated by Carlisle. Carlisle still thinks that even if you're turned to a vampire, you still essentially have a soul, which is against the general myth of what a vampire is supposed to do. And so you can still have some kind of enlightened existence, and you don't have to go around killing everyone. When he was unconscious and both his parents had died, and he was very much on the road to death and probably come to terms with death, and woke up in this sort of purgatory state which he doesn't appreciate, and he's pretty much fixated on either dying or becoming human again. And he doesn't see what the point of his life is at all in this vampire state. I mean, he's just trying to find some kind of meaning. I mean, he just sees absolutely no point to his life at all. And I guess when Bella arrives and he can have a connection with the living world again, which is basically one of his only options, is either die or connect with the living world, and Bella allows him to do that. And he can see and feel again through her. It's strange because for two characters who obviously don't know themselves that well, like Bella doesn't really know why she's falling for this guy and like having this bizarre feeling, and Edward definitely doesn't know hardly anything about himself. I never thought that we would find what we're holding in our hands. Oh, lately. And yet they both know that this is the thing, and that's the completely unshatterable fact that they both have to be with each other. I've been thinking I should make you mine. Been thinking that we should define what we are, oh, oh. And you know I love to be in control, but recently I don't know what to do. It's quite fun when you're harnessed. I mean, doing essentially things that you could do as a human. I mean, humans can climb trees, but because of all the sort of rigging and stuff, you can just be completely reckless with it. That's fun.
recently. I don't know what to do. Losing it over you.
I am super bumming that I can't be there. I'm in Toronto right now, but my heart is with you. I feel like we all kind of grew up together. You know, it's been 10 years. It's like crazy to think about that, but I love you guys and I'm totally there in spirit, and have fun today.
Hey, Rob.
Hey, what's going on?
No, I didn't know. Thanks for
guys. I haven't seen you guys for ages.
We were just talking about your music, Rob.
Oh, no.
That's okay. Okay. A few thousand of your best friends in the audience and some of your fellow castmates here. If there's one thing you want to convey to the fans 10 years later, what's the message you'd want to say to them? If they can't see you in person, what do you want to express about what this franchise, what this film has done for you?
I mean, it's the most important job. I mean, it's complete. It's, I just keep hearing like I'm getting laughs. I don't really understand what's happening. It's a complete life changing thing. I've never performed. Thank you.
Had the famous audition. We're searching for the perfect Edward, and he had to look like he was still in high school. So, like, Henry Cavill was really too old by that point. And we had the top four. It was like The Bachelor. You know, my top four best guys came over to my house, and every 2 hours.
I mean, Catherine. you gotta watch that mouth there.
But every 2 hours, Kristen did another scene and had to kiss another guy. And then at the end, she said, it has to be Rob.
Things I've been waiting to say, held in my heart for a day like today. I want to hold you till the light fades away. I want to hold you till the light fades away.
One more try. Yeah, go for it, Rob.
I just wanted to say that. I just wanted to say thank you to Catherine. Thank you for everybody involved for giving me the opportunity, the genuine life-changing thing. Thank you to all the fans for being so supportive and loyal. I mean, I don't think fan base would like to see this huge crowd still have 10 years. It's just wonderful.
Okay. Hey, buddy. We really appreciate you taking the time out, man. I know we had some technical difficulties. We're going to iron out the technical problems for the 20th anniversary in 10 years. It's going to be perfect. And anything you want to say, Catherine? Yeah.
Yeah, go for it.
Thank you, Rob. We miss you and love you. It's Catherine.
thank you, Seth. Yeah, let's hang out soon.
Okay.
Thanks, Rob.
It was amazing. The fans here were, you know, it's just really nice to see really friendly, genuinely interested faces. They've always been lovely all the years I've been doing this. And it's been a little while, so it's kind of nice to come back to it and see so many people still so receptive and excited. I wanna hold you to the light.